Welcome to Catastrophic News Sunday, where I give you all the macro, we throw it in a blender, and then we go all in on NVIDIA. Also, for those of you that do not understand sarcasm, this is not a channel for you. I actually got an email, because that was a joke. This young lady said I went all in on NVIDIA, like you said. That is not what I'm saying. You see, sarcasm is the farthest thing from the truth, and then I say, do it, and it's funny, it makes you laugh. That's why it's sarcasm. But anyways, we are going over the things that are happening today, tomorrow. Hopefully you guys purchase diapers because the next few days will be horrific. So let me be very clear with you. Should you go buy diapers? That sounded like advice. The answer is yes. Should you go all in on this? This was super micro computer. Got up to almost, there's a wick. Some Yahoo went in at 1100. Oh no, and then you post on Twitter. I'm losing all my money because now it's at 800. 1100 to 800 in one day. No problem, but that's a penny stock. There were over 34 million shares traded. That ain't no penny stock. Also, what I want to show you in this video, this is us. We're America, driving 2,000 miles an hour off a cliff, but we're going to be okay. Because Biden's going to save us, Trump's going to save us, and the stock market went up. And please don't worry about the global recession, UK, Japan, China, Germany, everywhere, recession, it's going to be fine. Or an inverted yield curve, or Citibank saying that we're done. Or I'm sorry, fall into recession. But what I want to do is I want to pull back and look at the big picture and go, look, how are you going to fix this? You're not. Wages have fallen relative to the economy. This is coming in from GOAT, everything. See this line, right? The trend is your friend. Wages, you know, the things you need to buy things, but the things keep going up. Then the government keeps lying. And also, could you subscribe to my channel? YouTube and I are in a little fight right now because I say things like Trump. That word will get you kicked off. How about recession? Or how about anything that Janet Yellen picks up the phone? She's like, yeah, can you silence them? So then the YouTubers, the Google goes, brrr. So if you ever want to see me, which I know, it's probably not a good idea. You're probably going to have to hit the little bell notification. I know you only get one notification a day. That's it. I pinky promise. And maybe you don't have to go search for me. J space B or who's Kitty? Yes, I know she needs to get her own show. But what? Actually, I have to have her on. She kind of made me upset. Asked her to take notes for me and you should see what she wrote. Maybe it's because she has those big hands. I don't know. We'll address that too. But big picture, look. Chapter 11 bankruptcy filings. Well, this is fine, right? I'm going to go with no. But everything's okay. Oh, no. We just begun. Bravo, the market went up. Well, I got this one for you too. U.S. money supply, also known as debt, right? Debt is money in a debt-based system. First time since the Great Depression, you've ever seen anything like this. What followed that was the Great Depression. What's going to follow this? Depression number two. But Big Pharma will come out and solve you. Oh, you feeling depressed? We got your back. Actually, that would be another word I can't say on this channel, but market went double top. And I'm sure everything's great on a double top, right? Also, just to let you know, on a double top, that does not mean short it right there, okay? That means it has to go up, confirm neckline, break neckline. That's where you short. Also in this video, and I want you to think about this, what is the most important thing? Because you're saying everything's going to go bad. Well, where should I be? Should I be in stocks? Should I be in bonds? Should I be in gold? Should I be in silver? Should I be in Bitcoin? Well, actually, the answer is going to surprise you. Well, that was the answer that I had Kitty write down, and she wrote something else down. Then I was like, wait, what did I say? Now, something very important. Tax refund tracker. Yes. No, not yet. Come in 1 minute. Yes, I know. You heard your name called. You let me in now? No, wait. Okay, so check this out. Your income coming in. This is right now. I'm going to show you. Tax refund tracker. Refunds down 57% in the first 2 weeks of tax season. Next few weeks, well, then it'll probably pick up. And I say, I don't think so. Look at 2022. This is the yellow line. Wow, that's great. Everything great. See, you're above that black line. Yay, refunds. Yay, everyone's paying lots of taxes. Money's moving around. 2024, that's the green. Do you see this? Huh, negative. huh, negative. Guys, this is horrible. But Bravo, you know what's going to fix it is population, right? Nothing's going to fix this, you guys. There's less people every single day. Look at China. I'll show you. Look at us. Year over year change in U.S. population. Okay. All right. Let's take a look. Good or bad? Do you see a trend? I see a trend. And let me move out of the way. Here is us. Who's going to pay for all of these taxes? Not us. Well, how about China? China'll say no. Do you see a trend of humans? The trend is your friend, you guys. Nothing's going to fix this. Our population, almost 1 million. The country's population fell by roughly 850,000 in 2022. 2023, another million. 2024, another million. It just keeps going. So as the world contracts globally, my question is, who's going to pay for all of this? I mean, I already know the question. You're paying for it. You have to. And not just that. Right now, the Treasury, so you have Janet Gobert, she's creating bonds, debt right out of thin air. During the pandemic, they tacked on, right? Oh, so much, 27 trillion, right? It was so bad. We're out of that and we're still going nuts, 34 trillion. But it's not just that. It's that you have to pay it back in your taxes, 250,000. On top of what you already owe. And with trillions and trillions of debt that they're unsustainable, they're tacking on what? What was GDP? Like, oh, yeah, 2%. I mean, that's where we're going. It's everything's bass backwards. And looking at these numbers, 39,000, which I have a daughter, six, one of them, LA, I think she makes 80, and she's like, it's basically poverty level. So 39,000 must be severe poverty. But look at this, going from 32 to 39 in what, 24 years? 24 years, you've tacked on nothing. Manufacturing jobs, you've lost. Pretty sure living in poverty has gone up. Here's you actually trying to get a job where we manufacture things. This is actually middle America is dying. And DC, don't care. But I mean, the politicians will come out there and be like, yeah, we care. 30 years ago, more than 10,000 people worked here at the steel company. And it's all gone. And with no one working, that's where Bank of America comes out and says, well, you know what we're seeing? Global Research tax refund tracker, refunds down 57%. But yes, Bravo, but NVIDIA went up. Now the question is, breaking news, how do we fix it? Well, I had, you can come in here now. Guys, so I have Kitty in here. She took notes for me. Kitty, can you please read off the notes that I had you write down for me?
Sure. How to make money when everything goes down like Chinatown.
Did I say Chinatown?
No.
Okay, thank you. Cue the fire. She added it. Chinatown. I'm like, what was I saying? She's like, well, I added that. I'm like, how is that even stop? Now I want to answer. Breaking news. What is the greatest thing that you can, I feel like Ty Lopez right now, when the market, everything goes bad? It's actually knowledge. And actually, for those of you that don't know what I just said, this was Ty Lopez. He was filming in his garage, right? Probably a borrowed Lambo, all the lighting, right? Refilm it. Who knows how long? Spend lots of money on marketing because it's the books. He points to the books. Knowledge. But he's actually right. And it's sad when people come out with, it's like this little bit of truth, but you know, a lot of lie. No, Ty, I'm not calling you a liar. I've had these people call me and like, you got to delete that. I'm not even kidding. You got to change your title. He makes more than that. So anywho, but I think the greatest asset is to know how to go make money when the market goes down. Who knows this? Who knows how to make money going down? No one knows how to make money going up. Well, everyone. Everyone's like, you just buy. Hey, buy and hold. Because look, Bravo, clearly, if the market always goes up, right? No, but what they don't share with you is like from there all the way to there. Yeah, right. You're like, oh, I almost broke even. No, you know, you're waiting 30 years or going back that way. 30 years. It's 30 years you are down. Now the question is, what about this one? Because what goes up comes down. It always does. Just ask Newton. And then it finds a baseline. So now also, yeah, but the Fed's going to pivot. Every time the Fed pivots, the market goes down. Just so for those of you that are waiting for that. But isn't that crazy that I could equip you with knowledge on things like, oh, all gaps get filled. Huh. So that means there's a 99.9% chance that the market's going to go down there and fill that one and fill that one and fill that one. Well, it always has. Or how about when you get into areas like this called overbought, back there, and it sells off. How about this? How about having knowledge that you are in a rising wedge? What's going to happen? It's going to break to the downside. And actually, my indicator, it was right there. It's off. You're still in it. But when Bravo wins, when break? Well, it's coming. Now my question is, do you have the knowledge to make money going down? I mean, everyone knows how to make money going up. You click the buy button. But then do you have the knowledge to click the, not just the, well, it'd be the sell button if you just want to make small percentages. Do you have the knowledge on options? Which I've showed you over and over and over because I have watch lists. And yeah, it's not all of them go up. Someone's like, oh, you never talk about the ones that go down. Well, if you trade, you'll see them. Or when I go, when I say like TLT, oh my gosh, that's been like the thorn in my side for 2 years. Pretty open and honest, up 40% on that one. I go, just show you this one up 254%. But as you know, I put it all out there every single day. I work, I come here every day and I teach you how to up or down. This down is going to make people so rich. Well, that's if you have the knowledge on how to make money going down. Also, in the comments section and emails, when are you going to do, you know, 80% off on the swing trade? When are you going to do, like, I change it up, you know, throughout the month. Why don't we just do this? Since I threw everything at you, I will do 80% off of whatever course you want. How to make money going down, 80% off. How to make money going up, 80% off. How to buy a contract by making money up or down, 80% off. So that way you have the knowledge to make your digits go up when it's times are bad. You're not going to make money when there's blood in the streets. You make money on the way to the blood. See, everyone's like, oh, I'll wait till the bottom. You won't know the bottom. You have to do work and find the stocks that are traveling up, that are traveling down. Also, I get, what do I give, like a week free on my options watch list? Check it out. Go like, dang, this guy's calling it. Or my bear market, he called it again. Or my bull market, because there's different markets. Guys, this one on the way down will be epic. I guarantee, well, I can't guarantee anything. But actually what I can guarantee is you're still like break even for 3 years on the 2000, right? Like, frustrating, but it's okay. I will do this every day, whether you try a course or not, to give you the knowledge you need to make your digits go up. And we can also joke around and have a good time while it's going up and down and looking at macro. But anywho, love you guys. Enjoy your weekend. Oh, you even get tomorrow too, if you're an employee. I just talked to my window cleaner. He's like, yeah, I need to know, man, because he cleaned my windows and I wrote him a check. I'm like, how much did you make yesterday? Again, start a side hustle. He said, I made $1,550 yesterday cleaning windows. And I know some comments were like, oh, here we go with the cleaning windows. You could have done this at 13. And now I noticed he had two other people on the job site. And I'm like, oh, what are they? Well, they're not employees. I'm like, ah, oh, that's smart, but there's caveats. Now what he's telling me he's gonna do is he's like, I'm trying to make all this money and then sell the business. I'm like, that's a great idea. See, that's what I want you to do. Start a business, maybe just keep it forever. And if you like cleaning windows, clean windows. Or you can sell it and then travel the world and find out you'll want to go back to work. Because traveling is exhausting. Also, for those of you that see me on location at places, just know I don't want to be there. I know you're like, look, it's a beach. You're like, oh my gosh, I wish my life was like that. Sorry, I have to learn how to complete sentences. It's very, very, very difficult. You want to know what a vacation is to me? Just, you know, living in my house, sleeping in, waking up, going on a walk, traveling, not a vacation, not relaxing. You actually have to go on vacation when you get back from a vacation. Also, if you consume what's called ethanol, it's even worse. But again, I rambled, but that's just my truth, and I will see you tomorrow.